Chad, I have a microphone. Thank you all for coming tonight. It's winter is approaching, and it's dark outside, and I greatly appreciate you guys braving that as you came to the concert tonight. Well, we'll hopefully brighten up your evening and warm you up with some really beautiful music today. I want to thank our dear colleague, Kirsten Whitson, for joining us today. Patricia Ryan, our regular cellist, has been under the weather, and she's now has recovered, but she's ready and raring to play. But this particular week was a rather busy one for us. We were touring in Iowa, and we had a bunch of concerts this week, so we thought we would better let her rest and heal up. And Kirsten has done a magnificent job joining us, so thank you. And we're also going to welcome our dear friend John Jensen to the stage to play that little ditty, the Brahms Piano Quintet, which is a magnificent piece of music. And he will talk about that later. The piece that we're going to play right now was actually selected by Patty Ryan to play. So we decided, out of respect for her decision to play this piece or select it, she knows Jotin very well and actually was a student of his at San Francisco Conservatory. So we're just going to play one movement of it tonight and hopefully replay the other two movements later with Patty joining us. So I just want to mention it's not a complete piece, but we're going to play the first movement, which is very lovely. He was a very aspiring, he is a wonderful composer and highly lauded now in his 30s. He was 18, all of 18 when he wrote this piece in China. And then he came to, obviously the Curtis Institute thought he must have been good. This is one of the pieces I'm sure he submitted for it. And he was accepted into the prestigious Curtis Institute in Philadelphia. And that's where he got his degrees from. And you can look him up and see. He's primarily, just like Ravel and Debussy, loved the larger forms. And so he likes operatic pieces and large symphonies and things like that. But he did write two string quartets. So we're delighted to have them in the repertoire. And this was from 2000. And I hope you enjoy the first movement of Jotin's String Quartet No. 1. Thank you.
Good evening. I haven't used this mic before. Bear with me. I was asked to say a few things about the piano quintet you're about to hear, and I just got a hold of your program, and I looked at the program notes, and I went, I don't think I need to say anything, because they are so well written and conceived that they took everything that I was going to say to you and wound up in print. So there is one thing I wanted to let you know about that's not in your program notes that I took from a CD recording of the quintet with the Takash Quartet and Andras Schiff, very fine pianist, recorded years ago. And it's that in Germany in the 19th century, there were a lot of principalities and there were a lot of princesses and kings and queens, and there was a Princess Anna, who Brahms knew, and he dedicated the two piano version of the quintet to her, as well as the version that we're doing tonight. And in response, what she gave to him, and that proved to be one of his most prized possessions, was the autograph score of Mozart's 40th symphony. Yeah, so I read that and I went, oh, it's not in your program notes, but I'm assuming it's the truth because it was on an international release and I'm assuming that the program notes are correct. So that's something. And Brahms prized music from the past. He lived in the music of Bach, Beethoven, Handel, and all of his predecessors. And a lot of his contemporaries, Wagner and Berlioz and Liszt, they thought he was old-fashioned. Give me old-fashioned. Give me old-fashioned. Now, final commentary. Sylvester Visick, the MC who you just heard and saw, described this piece as being muscular. He was on to something.
Thank you. Thank you.